Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. In Gnosticism, the person, he learns the subject himself and in the company of some other fellow Gnostics. So, he himself has to be twice born. If he is once born, then he will just read the books, and after reading the books he will say, oh, I am become a Gnostic, you know. These university professors, you see them, they have read the books and they translated it and they did commentaries and other things, but without the grace of our Father, you cannot understand the hidden meaning in the parables. Although it's a very simple, you know, but still you have to think yourself. So that is one to stress, you know, that in Jesus we should be the living word of the living Father and not the dead letters of the Bible. So when you drive the logos is drived through logical reasoning. So when you sit in the company of fellow Gnostics, you should think logically. All the arguments, when it's on logical basis, then everything becomes clear. And when you have understood it, then you can open your mouth, preach gospel with authority. But most people, you know, when they learn a little bit, they don't want to open their mouth in case they annoy somebody. The result, what is they have got, is sooner or later taken away. So he is left worse than as before. So he will be left as confused. So in Jesus we have to be living in spirit, and Christ Paul has a valuable information in his epistles, and all those epistles should be understood in spirit. For example, Paul said, you know, a woman cannot teach. Now, many people don't, these university professors, many they don't know the difference between teaching and preaching. So when they hear that, oh, Paul said, you know, women cannot teach. Oh, how come? But they don't know, most of them, they don't know the difference between teaching and preaching. Teaching is scriptures. Scriptures which are the moral laws. And that teaching is in the hand of, used to be in the hand of the rabbis. Rabbis are to be all men, because they have to represent Adam. In Adam, only the men can represent. While in God, because there is no male and female, no sex involved, it's only soul, which is the same in man and a woman. So in God, you have to be again son of God. So when you are son of God, then you display the qualities of God. As Theresa, our brother Theresa of Calcutta, she represented mercy. She showed mercy to everyone, and that is the light of our Father. As the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he displayed the light of our Father. So you have to, you know, you have to work hard. You have to learn the basics. First, know Christ Thomas. Stress rightly, first know what you see with your two naked eyes. Then what is not seen would be known to you. What is not seen is of God, our Father. You cannot see His. The nature belongs to Yahweh and not to our Father God, what you see. But the life that makes them living belongs to our Father. So same, the soul inside you belongs to our Father, but not the physical body. Physical body is all governed by the Yahweh and His priest, rabbis. So there is too, this Bible has been, after the death of Jesus, Saint Stephen and Saint James the Just, the next bishops are the Jewish people who are occupying mostly, and they bring in the Torah from the temple, old utensil. And when they bring the Torah in, then the Jewish people came rushing into the church to increase the number. But when the apostle used to come, the people who are reading Torah, the old wine, they desireth not the new, which the apostle came to deliver. So the apostle rebuked the bishop. So these messianic Jews, they killed Christianity. And that is what Jesus said, the light came among his own, and they loved darkness. They hated light. So that's how they killed the apostles, by putting them before the animals and burning them at stake. Pope had been doing quite recently. So all those people who stand between man and God in the name of Jesus, put on these dog collars, are in any way stand between man and God, they are anti-Christ. So it's our duty. So we encourage them to ask questions. Ask, seek, and knock. So when they are asking questions, first time maybe asking silly questions, but soon you will find that from those silly questions will come the sensible questions. When he start asking sensible questions, then he is twice born. When he is twice born, then he becomes a seeker of his word. So when he has sought them, you know, and have been preaching gospel, seeking, then he gets sealed to serve God. He would not love mammon then. He would not cheat anyone or fleece anyone. That is what, you know, the Christ Thomas's workers in India. No, Jesus had laborers and workers, you know. So the Christ Thomas laborers in India, South India, they were so enlightened and so honest, you know, that their business prospers. So in the world, always take care that you don't make profit too much. If you make profit too much, then the gap between rich and poor will increase. So as that gap increases, then the tension builds up. In a house, there are five, three against two, two against three. The three belong to the natural man, which are the tribal birth, that you are born white, brown or anything, and you are proud of your tribal birth. Then the second one is that you have acquired certain skills, say footballer, wrestler, and other people. They get if you ask them something, they say, oh, we are earning so much money, you know, so who the hell is this man asking us a question? They will not care to listen to him, but they will bounce with wrath. That means they will rebuke you rather than listen to you. So the third is egocentric. So you become at the ego of the reading of the holy books. And you don't like the people who are not well read. At the university professors, when I meet them, because I have no degree in theology, so they don't like to talk with me. They feel insulted, you know. But when I pull their legs, then they have no answers. These three are of natural man, and then when you become twice born, then you become, first you become clever, you know, that hey, I know more tricks than these simple-minded people. Then there you can have a doubting stage, whether to cheat the simple-minded people and become rich, or to serve God, in which case you don't make too much money. You make just enough to live, you know, they are happy, you are happy. Like these communist countries, over there, they kept the traders' profit down. So they were producing these goods and sold to the public at a very nominal profit, very small profit. Sometimes when you go to town, you see things being put on sale, 50% reduced, 75% reduced. But still the shopkeeper is making profit. He's not selling them at a loss. That is how much they earn, you know, from the public. That means they fleece. Russian are these communist people. They have very little margin, so they have no intention of fleecing people, and there's no point, there's not much disparity between rich and the poor, and they live in peace. And those people who are not cheat, and they are contented with their lot, they are not fleecing people, they are contented, they get sealed to serve God. And when they get sealed to serve God, then all those five, three of ego, two of mind, greed and worldly attraction, that you want to rule over the world, they all come under your control, and then you are sealed to serve God. So the Gnostics, they lead the Bible and they extract what they want. They know where the corruption has taken place. So they do not encourage corruption, but they rectify the what is written and present to the people. That makes sense, you know. Say, for example, the people in the John's Gospel 2, they are saying, Jesus saved you from the sin and all that. Well, he came. He came and introduced to our new home. In the new home, sins have no value. It is only in the old house of Rabbi. Then the sins counted in Adam. Because in Adam you need somebody to govern this sin. That is why they had priest. While in Jesus, we go by our righteousness. We search our own heart and put it right. So in Jesus, the sin are no more there. We are no more slaves to the sins, but to the righteousness. So we are governed by the righteousness of our heart, and that you do yourself. If you want to cheat somebody, then your heart knows before you act. So God bless you. God is our Father and not Lord. Lord has slaves, Father has sons. Inheritance is to the sons and not to the slaves. That is why those people who are once more, they address Jesus as Lord and even God, you know. How can we son equal to father or greater than father? So they are confused, you know, because of this messianic Jews bringing in their Jewish leaven into the church. So they don't know who is the creator, whether it's our Father God or the Yahweh. So our Father God blesses you.